If you have been wondering what TinyML is, every time you hear about it, let me tell you, it is the future. In this video, I will explain what TinyML is and why is it so important and help you get started with it. By the end of this video, you'll have a pretty solid foundation to begin your journey into TinyML. So let's get started. What is TinyML? TinyML stands for Tiny Machine Learning. Think of TinyML as teaching really small gadgets like home appliances, watches, to be smart, to understand things. Just like how we teach our brains to learn new stuff. It is when machine learning combined with embedded systems, the TinyML was born. It is more in refined terms, TinyML refers to deploying machine learning models on microcontrollers and other resources contained in. Traditional machine learning often requires significant computational resources and power. In contrast, TinyML optimizes models to run efficiently on a tiny device. Plus, you can hold on to the smart device on your palm. So let's discuss the benefits of TinyML in more detail. Energy efficiency. TinyML models are designed to consume minimal power, making them perfect for battery operated devices. 2. Low latency. Because the computations are done locally on the device, there's no need for the data to travel server and back, resulting in faster responses. 3. Privacy. Data processed locally means sensitive information doesn't need to be sent over the internet, enhancing privacy. 4. Cost effective. Deploying ML on inexpensive microcontrollers can drastically reduce the cost compared to the more powerful hardware. To get started with TinyML, you need a few things. You can take any microcontroller board that you already have, like Arduino Nano 33 BLE sensor, a ESP32, a WIO terminal, or even Raspberry Pi Pico, Pi 4, Pi 5, anything. You will need a TinyML framework. You can choose whatever suits you. However, my personal preference is the Edge Impulse, AI, FES, or a TensorFlow Lite. For microcontrollers, is also a good choice. TinyML enables machine learning algorithms to run on small, low-power devices. These devices can perform tasks like anomaly detection, speech recognition, image classification, and more. By optimizing the machine learning models to fit within the constraints of this device, TinyML makes it possible to bring the advanced AI capabilities in everyday objects. For instance, imagine a wearable fitness tracker that can analyze your activity in real time, a smart home device that can detect unusual patterns of energy usage, or a toy that can interact with a children in a more intelligent way. This typically involves four steps. One is collecting data, gathering the data relevant to the task, such as sensory. And second one is training a model, using this data to train the machine learning model, often on a more powerful computer. Three, optimizing the model. Then we need to convert the trained model into a lightweight format suitable for the microcontroller. Four, and finally, uploading the model. Uploading the optimized model to the microcontroller where it can make predictions based on the new data. TinyML opens a world of possibilities from smart home devices to health monitoring wearables. The potential applications are vast. Check out our next video where we would be teaching in detail how to interface your Raspberry Pi Pico with Edge Impulse and then making your very own fitness tracker with TinyML and a Pico. We also have the entire series on Arduino TinyML kit and link is pinned in the description. That's all for this video. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video and want to see more content like this, please hit the like button and subscribe to our channel. Leave a comment below with any questions or suggestions for future videos. Until next time, happy tinkering.